We're going to answer the question, what is dilution in this video? Let's just say we happen to have a container filled with potassium permanganate solution. The volume is half a liter and the concentration is 0.075 molar. When we add water to the solution, take note on how the concentration reduces from 0.075 to 0.067 and then to 0.060 and finally to 0.054. As we add more and more water, the concentration becomes smaller and smaller. That is what we call dilution. We start with something concentrated and then we add water or we add solvent to the solution and the solution becomes diluted. And that's what dilution is all about. So throughout the dilution, the amount of potassium permanganate did not change. I didn't remove any of it or add any more KMnO4 solid to the solution. The only thing that was added was just water, which is the solvent in this case. So that means the amount of potassium permanganate, meaning the moles of potassium permanganate before and after the dilution, remained the same. Let's prove that. Before dilution, the concentration was 0.075 moles per liter and the volume was 0.504. Now, using the molarity formula, we need to find moles, right? So let's rearrange a little bit and we plug in the numbers and we get 0.038 moles. That means before dilution, the moles of KMnO4 that is in the solution was 0.038 moles. Now, after the dilution, the concentration is 0.054 moles per liter and the volume has increased to 0.7 liters. Plug in the values and we get the moles is 0.038 moles. Well, what do you know? That's the same as the moles before the dilution. So we have proven that the moles of solute before and after dilution is the same. Solute in this case is potassium permanganate. That means the molarity times volume of solution before dilution is the same as molarity times volume of solution after dilution. In short, it's M1V1 equals M2V2. One is before dilution, two is after dilution. Sometimes you may hear one as concentrated or stock solution, two as the diluted solution. On occasion, you may encounter dilution problem that involves percent concentration rather than molarity. The idea is still the same. It's just that now you substitute concentration for molarity. So the formula changes to C1V1 equals C2V2. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.